Alright, so in today's class, we are going to discuss integration of the functions of the form 1 upon s and 1 upon ax plus b. So for example, if you have a function such as 1 over x and you are being asked to integrate it, the rule says that integration of function 1 upon x is going to be ln x plus b. If you remember the differentiation of ln x, if y was equal to ln x, then differentiation of ln x was 1 upon x. So integration of 1 upon x is going to be ln x. Now, if you have a function that is in the form of 1 upon ax plus b, then the rule says that, let me just remove this. If you want to integrate 1 upon ax plus b expression, then these are reciprocal functions. Integrations of such functions is always in the form of ln. So over here, when we were integrating 1 over x, if I ask you what was the differentiation of x, you're going to say 1. So if that is the case, that when the differentiation of the denominator is present in the numerator, then the integration is equal to ln of the denominator. Okay, so if you have a function 1 upon ax plus b, if I apply the same rule over here, what is going to be the differentiation of ax plus b?
A.
Is a present in the numerator?
No.
No. But I can make some adjustment by multiplying the numerator by a. If I do that, I'll have to divide by a outside the integral sign so that I'm not changing the question. So if now the expression is a upon ax plus b and you have the differentiation of the denominator present in the numerator, then the integration of such function is going to be ln of the denominator, that is ax plus b. So 1 upon a as it is times ln of the denominator, that is ax plus b plus c. Now, we know that when we were dealing with logs, we know that log of a negative number is not defined. So ax plus b should be greater than 0. And x must be greater than 0 over here. Is the rule clear?
Sir, could you explain the 1 upon a part again? I didn't get that.
Let me explain it to you with the examples.
Okay.
If you are asked to integrate 5 upon x dx, can I take 5 come out outside the integral sign?
Yeah.
Because it's a constant number, I can take it outside the integral sign. And what is going to be the integration of 1 upon x?
X plus c.
Integration of 1 upon x, as per this rule, is ln x.
Okay.
Because you have the differentiation of the denominator present in the numerator, the differentiation of x is 1. That's why the integration of 1 upon x is going to be ln x plus c.
Okay.
For part B, you are given 6 upon 2x plus 5. So you can take 6 common out, outside the integral sign. Now this conforms to an expression which was given over here, 1 upon ax plus b. Now what is going to be the differentiation of 2x plus 5?
So ln 2x plus 5 plus c.
The differentiation of 2x plus 5 is 2. So you times the numerator by 2 so that you can apply log. If you times the numerator by 2, you will have to divide by 2 outside the integration sign. So 6 over 2 is 3 and the integration of 2 upon 2x plus 5 is going to be ln 2x plus 5 plus c.
Okay.
If you get this, can you try part C now?
Yeah.
So integration of 8 upon 3 minus 4x can be written as 8 times integral of 3 minus 4x dx. So I need to realize that if I want the differentiation of the denominator in the numerator, I'll have to multiply this by negative 4. So I'm going to divide the term outside the integral by negative 4. This is going to result in negative 2 ln 3 minus 4x plus 3. Is this the answer that you got?
Yeah, sir, that's the same one.
Okay, great. Let's try a few more.
Okay.
So, integration of 5 upon 2 times 5x minus 1. Now, I'll advise you not to multiply 2 with the bracket. Instead, pull out half as common outside the integral. So, you are going to get 5 over 5x minus 1 dx.
Okay.
Now, I can see that the differentiation of the denominator is present in the numerator. So, 1 upon 2 ln 5x minus 1 plus c. Would you agree with this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let's try the next one. All right. Now, if you look at the denominator, what do you see over here? There are two functions being multiplied together. The two functions are?
X and e to the power x.
10x e to the power
x. Sorry, 10x and e to the power x.
Yeah. Now, it would be helpful for me if I split the terms. Can I write it like this?
Yeah.
Now, if you notice, I can simplify these out. So, over here, I'm going to get e to the power of 3x over 2. And over here, I'm going to get 1 over 5x. Are you getting the same answer?
Yes, sir.
All right. I can take 1 over 2 outside the integration sign. 1 over 2 times e to the power of 3x minus 1 over 5 integration of 1 over x dx. So what is the integration of e to the power of 3x?
E to the power of 3x upon 3.
E to the power of 3x over 3. So half times e to the power of 3x upon 3 minus 1 upon 5. What is the integration of 1 over x?
Ln x plus c.
Ln x. And as a final step, you're going to add constant of integration. Combine. This is going to be the combined constant of integration.
Okay.
You were integrating this. So that it should have a constant of integration over here. You were integrating 1 over x, it should have a constant of integration. But because the two constant of integration are just the constants, you can write it a capital C and call it a combined constant of integration.
Okay.
Okay, then e to the power of 3x upon 6 minus 1 upon 5 ln x plus c. That should be your answer. Okay. Right?
Yeah.
Do you need time to copy this?
No, sir, I've copied.
Okay. Now try this question.
Okay.
Okay, so you have a curve that has a gradient expression as 2x plus 5 over x for x greater than 0. Given that the curve passes through these points, e comma e square, you need to find the equation of the curve. So you are going to integrate the gradient function y equals to 2x squared over 2 plus integration of 5 upon x is going to be 5 ln x plus c. Is that right?
Yeah.
Are you with me till here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then substituting this point, e square equals to e square plus 5 ln e, what is the value of c? So c comes out to be negative 5 ln e. And ln e is 1, so c comes out to be negative 5.
Yeah.
Therefore, the equation becomes y equals to x squared plus 5 ln x minus 5. Okay?
Yeah.
Are you getting the same answer?
Yeah, sir.
All right. Try this one.
Okay.
So dy by dx is equal to 1 over x plus e. If I integrate this, integration is going to be ln x plus e plus c. The point is given to us, y is 2 plus ln 2 when x is e. So this is going to be e squared. This, using the rules of indices, this 2 can come over here, and this is going to be 2 ln e. And 2 ln e is just 2.
Oh, sir, wouldn't it be 2e?
Yeah. My bad. Sorry. This is going to be ln 2e. Ln 2e plus c. ln 2e can be written as ln 2 plus ln e. Ln e is 1, so c comes out to be 2 minus 1, that is 1. Therefore, the equation is going to be y equals to ln x plus e plus 1, right?
Yeah.
Okay, try this one.
Okay.
Alright, so the question says, given that y is equal to x plus 5 over square root of 2x minus 1, you need to show that the differentiation comes out to be equal to this.
Yeah.
So the first part is related to differentiation. Now, if you see, you have a fraction, so you can go for quotient rule, right?
Yeah.
This is u, this is v. So dy by dx is going to be equal to vu prime minus uv prime over v squared. U is x plus 5. V is 2x minus 1 to the power of half.
Yeah.
U prime is going to be 1. V prime is going to be half times 2x minus 1 to the power of half minus 1, which is minus half, times 2. So this gives you 1 over 2x minus 1 square root.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
This is V prime. So V U prime 2x minus 1 to the power of half times U prime, that is 1, minus U x plus 5 times V prime, which is 1 upon 2x minus 1 square root over V square. V square is going to be 2x minus 1. Now, if you see, you can write 2x minus 1 to the power of half as square root of 2x minus 1 as well. If you make the denominators common for these two terms, you're going to get 2x minus 1 square root. 1 times 2x minus 1 square root. This is going to give you 2x minus 1 minus x plus 5 divided by square root 2x minus 1. So the answer comes out to be 2x minus x is x, minus 1 minus 5 is minus 6. Okay, also, just a second. We also had 2x minus 1 in the denominator. So now simplify this, 2x minus x is going to be x minus 6. Over square root of 2x minus 1 times 1 upon 2x minus 1. So this is going to be resulting in x minus 6 over 2x minus 1. What was the answer given in the, this is the form that you were asked to show. So to the 3 over 2 can be written as 2x minus 1 cube and the entire thing in square root. Do you understand this?
Sir, could you explain the last step?
The last step had, when you multiply 2x minus 1 square root with 2x minus 1, you are going to get 2x minus 1 to the power of 3 upon 2.
Yeah.
And to the power of 3 over 2 can be expressed as 2x minus 1 cubed square root.
Okay.
Okay, now the second part uses a command word hence, and you are very well aware that hence would indicate that you have to use the answer from the previous part to solve this. You are asked to find hence, find the integration of x minus 6 upon 2x minus 1 cube. What do you think the answer to this is going to be? What is going to be the integration of this?
It would be the original equation, the y equals to x plus 5. Yeah, plus c.
Exactly. X plus 5 over 2x minus 1 square root plus c.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. If you are asked to differentiate, this is the next question. If you are asked to differentiate x ln x with respect to x, we can use the product rule, right?
Yeah.
U is going to be x, v is going to be ln x, for example. So u prime is 1, v prime is, what is the differentiation of ln x?
1 upon x.
1 over x. So dy by dx, the differentiation for this term is going to be u v prime plus v u prime. U is x, v prime is 1 over x, v is ln x, and u prime is 1. So simplifying this will give you 1 plus ln x as your derivative.
Yeah.
Now, let's try to understand what is the second part asking us. Hence, find integration of ln x dx. So they have used the command word hence, that is going to indicate you that you can use the answer or the working from part one.
Yeah.
So if I use the working from part one, dy by dx is equal to 1 plus ln x. To find the integration, I can integrate both sides. Now, this would mean that I have to integrate 1 with respect to x as well, and I have to integrate ln x with respect to x as well. And integration of dy by dx is y.
Okay.
Integration of dy by dx is going to give you y, the original function. And integration of 1 dx is x plus integration of ln x. Now, this is the question that you were asked. To find the integration of ln x. So to find the integration of ln x, I can just take x to that side. So integration of ln x will be equal to y minus x. Now there wasn't any y given in the question. I substituted y for x ln x. So again, I'm going to replace it with x ln x minus x, and then a combined constant of integration.
Okay.
So that is going to be your final answer.
Okay.
Excellent.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Do you need time to copy this, or are you done?
Yes, sir. Could you just give me a minute?
Sure. So for the first part, to differentiate this, the differentiation is going to be 3x squared minus 1 to the power 5 times 3x squared minus 1 to the power 4 times the differentiation of inside bracket, that is 6x. So 30x times 3x squared minus 1 to the power of 4. That is the solution to the first part.
Okay.
Now part B says, hence find the integration of x times 3x squared minus 1 to the power 4. So I'm going to use the answer from the first. 30x, 3x squared minus 1 to the power 4. Apply integration on both the sides. But see, the question says you need to find the integration of x, 3x squared minus 1 to the power 4, which is just this part.
Yeah.
So I can take this constant 30 to the next side.
Okay.
So if I do that, I'm going to get 1 over 30 integration of dy by dx is equal to integration of x times 3x squared minus 1 to the power of 4 dx. So integration of 1 upon 30 times integral of dy by dx is going to be 1 over 30 y plus c. This is equal to x times 3x squared minus 1 to the power 4 dx. So if I rewrite this, that's going to be 3x squared minus 1 to the power 4 dx equal to 1 upon 30 y. But y wasn't in the question. I substituted y as 3x squared minus 1 to the power of 5. So 3x squared minus 1 to the power of 5 plus 3. This is the answer for the integral of x times 3x squared minus 1 to the power of 4. Do you get it?
Sir, how did you get y plus c in the step on top of this?
Integration of dy by dx. 1 dy by dx is just y. And you must always add a constant of integration.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm integrating 1 with this. Integration of 1 dy by dx is y.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
That is going to be the final answer.
Okay.
Okay. Can I move on to the next question now?
Yes, sir.
Try this one.
Okay.